welcome to another episode of Afro Scientific Spirituality. My name is Efe West, reaching your life and direct from the heart of Africa. If this is your first time on the channel, you're highly welcome. This is the place where we separate the facts from the fiction, the science from the superstition, and the concept from the misconceptions about African spirituality. Today, I will be talking about the Orisha, or the African god called Osain, Osainyu or Osainye, or Aziza in West Africa. This is the god or the deity of the forests of nature, and it's a very, very important deity, and I want us to know about him today in African spirituality. It's a very, very important deity. He's regarded as a god of the forests. He's highly knowledgeable of all the secrets of plants, herbs, animals, and minerals in the forest, in the earth. So he's in charge of that department. That is his responsibility. So you need to know about him. He's very popular in West Africa and highly venerated. He's also a god of justice. He hates destruction of nature. He hates suppression. He usually always appears as an old man that is disabled. Sometimes people see him with only one leg. In my tribe in Nigeria, the Urhobo people, they know him as Aziza. He's one of the most prominent and most active deities in the Urhobo of God. There's nobody in Nigeria that will not know him, especially in Delta State. There's no person that don't know the god called Aziza. He's the one. The Yorubas call him Osain. He always appears with one leg and sometimes one eye and sometimes one hand. He always appears deformed and always limping. They say that he got that, according to the legends, he got injured while fighting to preserve nature and fighting to stop oppression or indiscriminate destruction of the forest or natural elements. Some stories say that he one time fought with Shango, the god of thunder, and he was injured during that fight. And but those are legend stories. But the fact that is the way he appeared, the way he chose to appear, is like always limping. Many people have seen him in Delta State. Many rural people have come across him in the forest. This is a deity that many people have seen how he does his work. There are people that go to fish, go to the jungle, go to the bush to hunt, to farm. They're always seeing him in the jungle. Sometimes he comes with lot of dogs. Sometimes he comes with a very strong winds. Sometimes he comes in different shapes and forms. But many people have seen him, and there are so many evil people are afraid of him because he's also a god of justice. When he comes around, he kills or destroys evil people, people that use magic or witchcraft to destroy their fellow men. He hates those kind of people, and he always comes after them. So evil people always run away from him. Those Nigerians that have some evil powers that they use to oppress other people, they are afraid of this deity. They don't like the deity because it's a deity of justice. So the witches and wizards in Nigeria, a lot of them, they hate him a lot. Those evil people that practice evil African spirituality, they don't like him. So, but if your hand is clean and you are a good person, you don't have any problem with this deity. This is a deity that is one of the guardian of the Urhobo people in Delta State. It is one of their ancestral deities that guides them and protects them. But in recent times, he have been forgotten due to the advent of Christianity. Christianity have now depicted the deity as an evil deity, as a devil or a demon. So many people are afraid to get contact with him. But he's still very, very active in Africa, even till this day. He's a very powerful deity. He's one of the Patreon on this channel. He's one of my Patreon deities, right from time. If you are interested in studying about herbs, you want to know the use of plants or the secret of plants and minerals, this is the deity that you really need to talk to. Osain is the deity you need to call, you need to be talking to. You want to know which herb to use to treat what, well, you want to know those kind of things. You want to be able to protect nature, to work with nature spirits, to preserve nature, and you want to stand for justice. This is the deity that you really need to call. It's very easy to work with. You don't need any form of initiation or whatever. You just need to set up an altar to him and you give offerings. You leave them in the jungle or in the mountains or in the bush. You call his name, you put his offerings in the bush, and just like that. Very easy to work with. So it's a deity that appears, it always deformed, and is a doctor, is a savior of humanity. They also regard him as the owner of the mountain, and is in charge of the mountains, vegetations. He has a lot of power and dominion over the earth and the underworld as well. So it's a powerful deity like that. Then he has his own followers. His followers in the Yoruba Patreon, they call them Osainists. These are heirs of the Osain legacy. And most of his followers, they are healers. They are people that they have knowledge of herbs and plants. And he's a very wise deity. Very, very wise deity. And if you want wisdom, you can be able to call him as well. Then if you are into medicine, like you are a doctor, you are treating people, whether you are a medical doctor, a native doctor, traditional doctor, herbal doctor, root worker, you need to know Osain. You need to actually make contact with him, because this is his department. He's in charge of medicine and health, and he also does spell works too. So there's a lot of ceremonies that people do to him. There's a lot of offerings people give to him. And there are four main things that people call him for. People call him, maybe you want protection against negative spirit energies, negative spirits. You want protection for your house, for your family, you call him for that. If you want good luck and you want offering, you want good luck and prosperity in your life, people calling for that. If you want to be able to do spells, know how to mix herbs together, to mix different things together to make powerful spells with natural elements, you also calling for that. If you want to fight evil spirits, you want to chase away evil spirits, you also calling for that too. This is his main job. These four things is what people calling for. So he's the king of the herbs. Then they also have the cult of Osain or his followers, people that actually venerate him. He has his own group of followers in many tribes. So there are people that have dedicated themselves to him. And those people are like his priests, his priesthood in a way. He teaches them many things and shows them many secrets of the planet and how to use the natural herbs or elements in the planet to be able to heal people, to be able to make the world a better place. So those people, they are called them Osainists, and they have different rites and ceremonies that used to initiate them also too. His number is 3, and people use 3 to represent him. People also use 4 to represent him. In the bush, you can find that very quiet places near the river, near the stream, or even near the sea. You can find him in any natural place. The followers of Osain, the children of Osain, they are always balanced and matured people. They are very, very highly realistic and very, very pragmatic. His followers are people that they don't allow their emotions to influence their judgments of events or men. His followers are very, very intelligent and like to constantly investigate and inquire about nature. So he has lots of intelligent followers and people that venerate Osun. They are very, very curious and they are very wise people. He has his own unique set of people that are dedicated to him on this planet. He has his own children, his own crew. That's what you say. So we will see in Hall is a very, very powerful and active deity. He's very easy to work with. You can start by walking. You take his picture. You can put it in an altar. He's found in nature. You can go to nature to call him, leave food for him, leave presents for him in very quiet places. Talk to him. Tell him. Ask him to teach you about nature, to teach you how to conserve and preserve nature, to teach you the secret of herbs. Ask him for this. This is what he does. Ask him for protection. He's very, very active. He's very, very active. And he will come to you. Okay? You don't need any special initiation to work with Osain. Okay? He's in everywhere. There is natural vegetation. In all the bushes, all the forests, and the mountain is there. Okay? So you go to him. You call him. You can sing to him. People normally sing different songs to him. You can sing, you leave offerings for him, you ask him. By the time you do this about 3 times, I'm very sure that he will come to you and he will show you what you need to know or give you what you're asking for, because he's a very, very active deity. Okay, so that is Osain for you. In my tribe, we call him Aziza. Aziza. So he's one of my Patreon deity, as I have told you, very powerful deity. Then in Brazil and in Cuba, he's very popular as well, very, very popular. In fact, there is a book that somebody wrote. They call the book Treaty of Osain, Tratado de Osain Completo. It was written by a child of Osain called Glenn Dian in Cuba, I think so. It's a book that contains so many herbs and so many secrets of herbs and a lot of spells. They are in 3 volumes, but now they have now compiled everything into a single volume. But the problem is that it is not written in English, and to get the English version is very, very hard. Even me, I want to buy the book, but what is available is just the non-English version. It's on Amazon. They call it Tratado de Osain, Little Treatise of Osain by Gian Dian. So you can try to find this book. It contains thousands of herbs and their uses and their purpose and how to use them to do spells that have been written by follower of Osain. They call it Treaty of Osain. So if you are interested in knowing about secrets of herbs, try to get this book. The book is written for Babalawos, used exclusive by Babalawos, written in Portuguese. It's written for native doctors, Treaty of Osain. So there's a book on him that every Osain follower must read, must try to get. So you really need to know this deity if you are interested in herbs. Most of the things I do on this channel, the remedies I do, natural remedies, all this falls under the jurisdiction of Osain. So you should know that I work with Osain a lot. He's the one that brings all the secret of herbs to humanity. So if you are interested in knowing about herbs, secret of plants, and how to use them, Osain is the guy you really need to talk to. So you actually need to call him into your life. Okay. In Nigeria, we know him as Aziza, or Osain. In Delta State, we know him as Aziza. His other name is Osain. So you need to find that there are still shrines to him, a lot of shrines to him in Nigeria. So try to get to know him. Okay, he's going to teach you many things, more than me. We teach you so many things you need to know about herbs, about minerals, precious stones. He will teach you, he's very wise. He will teach you so many things you need to know about nature, about medicine. He's going to teach you all those things. So, okay. So please try to call him. Try to get in touch with him so that you can learn more about nature and learn more about herbs. Okay. So this is what I have for you today. Questions or comments are welcome. Once again, please like and share this video. Hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to get my videos as soon as I release them. And I'll be seeing you in the next video. So take care and bye. Peace.